greetings. Brother, I appreciate your questions. In my last video, I used a phrase which I hesitated to use. It was God's plan. I hesitated to use this phrase because it is often tossed out when no logical answer can be given. But in my last video, that was not the case. I followed it up with scriptural evidence of the plan and will of God. Let me give you some examples where the phrase, "It was God's plan," is misused and tossed out as a dodge. The first situation which I often encounter is when I debate someone from Mohammed's religion. When I challenge them and they have no logical answer, they say, "It was Allah's plan." Let me give you the most common case where this occurs. Those who follow Mohammed and the Quran claim to believe the Torah and Gospel, or Injil. In fact, the Quran demands that you respect the Torah and Gospel as equal with the Quran. Quran 2:136, "Say, we believe in God and what was revealed to us, and what was revealed to Abraham, Ishmael, Isaac, Jacob, and their descendants, and what was given to Moses and Jesus, and what was given to the other prophets by their Lord. We make no distinction between any of them." But then, brother, a curious thing always happens. As soon as the glaring problems between the Quran and the Torah are revealed, those who follow the Quran make distinction between the Quran and the Torah. The Torah refutes the Quran. But you will assert the Quran is true, and therefore the Torah must be wrong. The Torah must have been changed. Believe me, brother, this path of excuses has been repeated countless times since Muhammad. The follower of Muhammad claims the Torah has been changed. Then the Christian will point out that the Quran itself says the word of Allah cannot be changed. Quran 6:115, "And the word of your Lord has been accomplished truly and justly. There is none who can change his words, and he is the hearing, the knowing." Quran 18:27, "And recite what has been revealed to you of the book of your Lord. There is none who can alter his words, and you shall not find any refuge besides him." And even though neither ayat says only the Quran is unchangeable, this is the next argument you are taught to offer. Believe me, brother, this path of excuses has been repeated countless times since Muhammad. And if a follower of Muhammad is pressed how any man can change Allah's word, the Torah, we get, "It was the plan of Allah." Unfortunately, there is never any evidence to support this claim. In fact, brother, Islam making this claim of an invented plan by Allah fails from too many arguments for this video. But number one, do you really think it was Allah's plan to not just have one scripture corrupted, but every scripture ever sent before the Quran? Two, do you really think it was Allah's plan to cause Christianity by his act of deception documented in Surah 4, 157? Do you really think it was Allah's plan for Islam to be rejected by Christians and Jews, those closest to Muslims? Yet those are some of the unanswerable questions which claiming Allah's plan raises, brother. And that is why the claim of God's plan or Allah's plan is intellectually bankrupt when not supported by evidence. The problem, brother, is that Islam must claim the word of Allah, the Torah, has been altered. At the same time that Islam claims the word of Allah cannot be altered. You know you are embarrassed when you have to admit this, Ahmad. I am embarrassed for you when you have to make this foolish claim? So claiming Allah's plan when no such plan can be documented does not instill any sense of legitimacy in Islam, brother. But I want you to think, my friend, because God does have plans. In fact, God sent the prophets to reveal his plans to mankind. Amos 3:7, surely the Lord God Yahweh does nothing unless he reveals his secret counsel to his servants, the prophets. Genesis 18:17, then the Lord said, shall I hide from Abraham what I am about to do? Daniel 2:47, the king said to Daniel, surely your God is the God of gods and the Lord of kings and a revealer of mysteries, for you were able to reveal this mystery. John 15:15, I no longer call you servants because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I learned from my Father I have made known to you. So without question, God makes plans, and God carries out his plans, and no power in the universe can stop him. Psalm 33:10, the Lord foils the plans of the nations. He thwarts the purposes of the peoples. But the plans of the Lord stand firm forever, the purposes of his heart through all generations. Brother, that seems like God has control, not men. Don't you want to believe in the God who has control? Isaiah 14:26, this is what I've planned for the whole earth, and this is the hand that is stretched out over all the nations. For the Lord Yahweh of hosts has planned, and who can frustrate it? And as for his stretched out hand, who can turn it back? And no power in the universe can corrupt the word of God. But then I listen to you argue for Islam, brother, and you claim your Allah is all-powerful but cannot protect his Torah or his Injil. It was the plan of Allah. I listen to you argue for Islam, brother, and you claim that Allah's word was lost forever because he did not know it would happen? It was the plan of Allah. I listen to you argue for Islam, brother, and you claim that Allah's word was changed by Jews because Allah did not see it coming. It was the plan of Allah. I listen to you argue for Islam, brother, and you claim that Allah changed his eternal covenant because he was ignorant that the Jewish people would sin. It was the plan of Allah. I listen to you argue for Islam, brother, and you claim Jewish men corrupted the unchangeable word of Islam's Allah. It was the plan of Allah. I listen to you argue for Islam, brother, and every claim you repeat only proves your Allah is not God. And I have to ask you, brother, why don't you want to believe the prophets? Who has caused you to reject the plan of God that they revealed? Because that is really what Islam has tricked you into doing, brother. Islam does not confirm the message of the prophets. If Islam did, you would be allowed to read and know and understand their message, brother. And over, brother, you say things taught by Islam which are wrong according to the prophets. Now, I began by talking about God having a plan, and I talked about why it is a weak claim to make that God has a plan if you cannot document his plan. And I have documented his plan in the previous two letters to you. I challenge you to think about the real message of the prophets, brother. If you desire to honor and follow and please Almighty God, the only way you can do that is to respect their message. John 5:39, Jesus speaking, "Search the Scriptures, for in them you hope that you have eternal life, and they testify concerning me. And you are not willing to come to me, Jesus, that eternal life may be yours." It breaks his heart, brother, that you reject God and reject his plan for your salvation. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.